and in this session we are going to discuss about one of the encryption techniques, that is Playfair cipher. Playfair cipher is used by the sender to encrypt the data or message and then send it to the receiver to have a successful secure message transfer or communication. The Playfair cipher technique is considered as one of the strong encryption techniques because here, instead of encrypting single letter or bit, we will be encrypting the combination or pair of two letters of a plain text. Playfair cipher uses a 5x5 matrix for the encryption and decryption process, as you can see the image. The keyword which is used for encryption will be placed in this matrix cells. The matrix of 5x5 will be used for placing the keyword character from left to right and row wise. And once the letters of keyword are completed, the remaining letters of the alphabets A to Z, which are not included in the key, will be used to fill the remaining cells of the matrix. Then the one important thing that we need to remember is that we need to place the letters I and J always in one single cell of a matrix. The reason behind this doing is we have 5x5 matrix, which implies we have 25 characters can be stored in the matrix cell. But we have A to Z as 26 characters in our alphabets from A to Z. So to accommodate 26 characters in 5x5 matrix, we place I and J in one cell of the matrix. Let us take an example. We have a plain text of letters as attackers and the keyword is Playfair example. So first we need to create the matrix and then perform the Playfair cipher encryption. So let's form the matrix. First, we will place the first keyword letter in the matrix, that is T, then L, then A, Y, F, I. Again, remember we have discussed that we write I and J in the same cell. So we will write I and J instead of only I. The next letters are R, E, X. We will not repeat the duplicate letters. So next last letter we will be placing is M. The letters placed in the matrix are not repeated. So the remaining cells that are empty will be filled up using the letters from A to Z. And remember that we do not repeat the same characters. Now, from A to Z, A is already placed and so we will place B in the matrix. The next letters C, then D, G, then H, K, N, O, Q, S, T, U, V, W, and Z. So we have successfully generated the matrix for encryption using Playfair cipher. For encryption, we have to follow certain rules and we will discuss those rules. In that, rule number one is if the digraph consists of the same letters twice, that means we have two letters same in the plain text, or there is only one letter left by itself at the end of the plain text, then insert X between the same letters, or at the end of the plain text, insert the X and then continue with the rest of the steps. Then rule number two, if the two letters appear on the same row in the square, then replace each letter by the letter immediate to the right hand side of it in the square by cycling round to the left hand side if necessary. Then rule number three, if the two letters appear in the same column in the matrix, then replace each letter by the letter immediately below it in the square and cycling round to the top of the square if necessary. Then rule number four, that is the last one, it will form the rectangle for which the two plain text letters are two opposite corners. Then replace each plain text letter with the letter that forms the other corner of the rectangle that lies on the same row as that of the plain text letter. So now we can start the encryption process for the plain text is equal to attackers and key is equal to playfair example. So step number one, we will pair up the characters of plain text. That is, attackers will be read as AT, TA, CK, ER, and last letter is S. But according to rule, we will place the X letter with S to complete the pair. Now we will encrypt these pairs one by one. First, we have the pair as AT. We will locate the letters A and T in the matrix and form a rectangle whose two corners will consist of A and T. As you can see, the rectangle in the red one. That is, we will first encrypt A. So we find the letter that is in the same row of A and also the corner of the red rectangle. And we get the letter T as the ciphertext of letter A. Then same way for T. We find the letter that is in the same row of T and also the corner of the red rectangle. And we get the letter V as the ciphertext of letter T. So we have encrypted AT as PV. Next pair is TA. We will locate the letters T and A in the matrix and form a rectangle whose two corners will consist of T and A. Then we will focus on encrypting T. So we find the letters that is in the same row of T and also the corner of the red rectangle. And we get the letter V as the ciphertext of letter T. Then same way for A, we will find the letter that is in the same row of A and also the corner of the red rectangle, which implies P as the ciphertext of letter A. So we have encrypted T A pair as V P. Next pair is CK. We will locate the letters C and K in the matrix and form a rectangle whose two corners will consist of C and K. Then we will first encrypt C. So we find the letter that is in the same row of C and also the corner of the red rectangle. We get the letter B as the ciphertext of letter C. Then same way for K. We find the letter that is in the same row of K and also the corner of the red rectangle. And we get the ciphertext of K as N. So we encrypt CK pair as BN. Then next pair is ER. We will locate the letters E and R in the matrix. As we see, the letters E and R in the same row. So the rule 2 will be followed and the encryption will be done as the next letter of the plain text exactly. The letter E will be encrypted first. So we get X as the ciphertext for E because X is the next character on right hand side of E. Same way for encrypting R, we will find the next right hand side character of R and we get E as the ciphertext for letter R. So we encrypt E R as X and the last pair, that is SX. We will locate the letters S and X in the matrix and we form a rectangle whose two corners will consist of S and X. Then we will first encrypt S. So we find letters that is in the same row of S and also the corner of the red rectangle. And we get the letter Q as ciphertext of letter S. Then same way for X. We find the letter that is in the same row of X and also the corner of the red rectangle. And we get the letter M as ciphertext of letter X. So we encrypt S, X pair as Q and M. So this is how encryption is done for Playfair cipher of plain text is equal to attackers. Key is equal to Playfair example, which gives ciphertext as P, V, V, P, B, N, X, E, Q, and M. Before ending this session, I have mentioned some of the questions to be encrypted using Playfair cipher. You can write the ciphertext of these pairs in the comment section. First one, encrypt plain text Playfair using the key hidden. Second, encrypt the plain text attacking using the key example. And third, encrypt the plain text attacked using the key Playfair. So this was all about the session. If you liked and learned from this video, please do not forget to like, share and subscribe. Thank you.